Amidst isolation by the international community that's seen via sanctions by several countries, Russia has more than ever renewed its focus on ties with Africa, and that's seen through this week's Africa-Russia Business Summit. We are starting off with that. I am Vaila Ksasria, together with Paul Busharizi. Let's dive in. Thank you, Paul, for making time. We start off with the Africa-Russia Summit, where President Museveni is a part of. Let's talk about the offers that are being made by the Ugandan president to Russian investors. Some of these involve oil and gas, agriculture. We've seen this happen over time, being offered to Western countries as well as several other African countries. So let's talk about the involvement of Uganda with Russia and its these connections' impact on its relations with the rest of the world.
Well, as you said, it would be interesting to see how it works out, because we know that Russia is under sanctions. So, you know, they would have to, if it's to happen, they would have to work out the modalities of that happening. As for offering the same opportunities to the West, well, in agriculture, can you finish the opportunities in agriculture in Uganda? You can't. So, you know, the Russians take some. Okay, assuming they do, they take some. The West takes some. Oil and gas, we still have need, for example, for the refinery to be done. Not to mention there's still possibilities for exploration. So there's enough to go around.
Some of the offers that we've seen being offered to Russia at this moment by the president have also been offered to several other countries. And we do see agriculture, we see oil and gas. Now, I'm getting interested in knowing how these sectors that have been offered multiple times have still not brought very, very tangible development to the economy. Or maybe it has. You can just take us through and let us know what has come out of the constant offer of these sectors to investors all over the world.
Yeah, I mean, for economic purposes, it's tricky. But I suspect the Africa Summit is also a back, what they call a backdoor channel of communication, because I think it's safe to say that there are more people who don't want this war to continue than there are who want it to continue. And of course, Russia plays a key in whether it starts or stops.
And finally, Paul, the International Monetary Fund has revised the global economic growth by 0.2 percentage points to grow up to 3%, which means there is a bit of growth we can see at the moment in the global economy. What do you think has led to this? As well as, please comment on the 120 million that was given by the IMF to Uganda. What are we going to see this money doing exactly?
I think this is an old package. It's just being actualized now. I think it was announced, one that was announced a few years ago during COVID. And the IMF's money many times is for what they call balance of payment support, which is because you're not exporting, your dollars have reduced, yet you need to import, so they come to bridge that gap. And maybe some budget support, basically, that you're not raising as much revenue as you should, and we're giving you temporary relief as you get your act back together. So the 120 million, I suspect, will go towards things like that. It will not come to your shops or to your pocket directly and stuff like that, yeah.
All right. Thank you so much for the clarity. I know that whenever we hear mention of money coming to Uganda, we believe we are going to receive money as business owners, but thank you for clarifying that. We shall see you next time. And thank you so much for watching the Business Roundup. As we always bring every Friday, you have all your doubts cleared by Paul Busharizi, who was our analyst tonight. We shall see you next time. I'm Vaila Ksasria.